sing it with us if you know the words. Here we go.
Undertaking, the Basser Center started with a dream. This inspiring vision is ideally suited in cancer genetics research. So I say to you here, we will all work and we will all succeed making John and Mindy's dream a reality.
That is why we are here tonight.
In October of 2011, I was appearing on Broadway. Before going to the theater to perform a Sunday matinee, I just happened to catch a broadcast by Stacey Sager. Stacey talked about the history of cancer in her family and testing positive for the BRCA mutation. Her report prompted me to get tested because she publicly told her story. Saved my life. All of us here tonight have the power to save lives. I have the privilege of taking care of individuals dealing with these very difficult issues, and they inspire me every day. But despite our many successes, too many of the stories are sad ones, and our goal is to change this. There's the collaboration of patients and advocacy groups who are great allies. And just as important, a collaboration between supporters, such as all of you in this room, who provide us with the resources to get this work done. We can't tell you how much we appreciate it. Their great loss of faith is a catalyst for action, but also for hope. We at the Basser Center take cancer personally. We will continue our progress and continue to accelerate our work.
I love this woman. When Mindy and I started on the idea of a fundraiser more than a year ago, I had two non-negotiable conditions. The event had to be simple, and it had to be small. Well, I guess it's pretty clear who wears the pants in this family. Now, Mindy spoke of faith. I want to speak about fate. The fate that had two English majors at Penn meet their senior year in romantic poetry class. The fate that led us to the discovery of faith's tragic loss coming from a BRCA mutation. The fate that emerged from a Google search to a study done by Susan Domchak on the efficacy of prophylactic surgery. I believe it was fate that led to the creation of the Basser Center and its vital mission to eradicate BRCA-related mutations. Now, many of you know that I invest capital in my day job, but nothing I've done has matched the return on investment we've seen from the Basser Center. We are humbled to be honored this evening, and thank you for joining the fight. Too many BRCA-affected families, like the Bassers, have suffered too long. We need to stop this, and we will.
This gift symbolizes the beacon of hope that the Basser Center is shining around the world. It all started with you. So everyone here tonight thanks you for lighting the way for all of us, and most of all, for all those lives who will be touched, for all those lives who will live in great health for generations to come. Thank you from all of us.
It is an honor to stand here tonight. 13 years ago this month,
I lost my sister, Faith Basser, to BRCA-related ovarian cancer. When you lose a loved one to cancer, the pain is unimaginable. When you lose a loved one to BRCA-related cancer, you imagine the unimaginable for generations to come.
Let's give it up, please, for Mindy and Jon. Now I know you love Jon, I know you love Mindy, cause this many people came out when it's rainy and windy. Now we get plenty of musical inspiration for people who live their lives with dedication. That's right, also with style and innovation. Did you check out that sparkle and fur combination? Yeah, fundraising, that's a big old part, but nothing's bigger here than Jon and Mindy's hearts.
Tonight is special for another reason, too. It is my mother's 80th birthday. In the Jewish tradition, you light a yahrzeit candle for your loved one on the anniversary of their death. When we planned this event, I had no idea what that memorial date would be in 2015, but alas, my sister's yahrzeit is tonight. Once again, faith is with me. My lowercase faith is also with me as I look out into this room and see before me the sea of faces here to support this first ever Basser Center fundraiser. With your overwhelming support, we have raised an incredible amount of money for research that will help ensure other families don't ever experience the unimaginable. Let's bring new meaning to the unimaginable and imagine a world free of hereditary cancer. Thank you.
Okay, both my parents are biochemists. They're PhDs. And somehow, in this whole wide world, they popped out me. Seriously, even though I'm an Indian, there's no way I'd ever get into Penn. No, instead I use my pen to write these rhymes with both of my friends. They both work at NIH, doing cancer research. My dad used to work at Johns Hopkins, don't you know, cause he used to teach. But I'll tell you something that makes my pops irate. There's something deep down my father really hates. It's every single year he's got to do the same old dance and ask the government just to give him them grants. And y'all know about them budget setbacks and cuts. Tell y'all right now that ish sucks. And my dad comes home crying, cause he's got this deep down inside design that he wants to bring peace and power to the future. Is there a way for someone to come and suture this problem? There's two people solving it, Mindy and Jon, that's right, now we're revolving it.
Jon, you ready to wrap this?
Yeah, exactly.
Good evening. Just kidding. There are two primary reasons we're here this evening. First, to raise awareness, and second, to raise money. With more than 1,100 people in this room, I think we're off to a pretty good start on raising awareness. And thanks to our generous ticket and table buyers, this event is already a great financial success.
When we started on this, our expectations were nothing like what we're seeing tonight. And we have been absolutely blown away by the generosity and support of the folks in this room. It is so touching, means so much to us, and is going to make such a big difference. Our announcement is tonight we raised $8 million for the Basser Center.
The Basser Center's alight with larks. The Basser Center's gonna set it soon. So please the faith and look up to the moon.
Thank you, Jon.
This is my daughter, and she inherited my love for dance.
I inherited my walk from him, my curly hair, but you can't tell.
My eyebrows and my thumbs.
We both use our feet as hands.
Good. We share eyes and cheeks.
Look at this is what she inherited. She inherited that.
That's so good.
I inherited the BRCA1 gene mutation from my mother.
Mm-hmm. This is my daughter Myla, and she inherited my stubbornness.
What if we told you the most effective way to prevent getting cancer was to remove your breasts and ovaries? Not a great choice, right? But that's how it stands now for people born with BRCA mutations, and that's an improvement. Before identification and testing for mutations in the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes, most women with BRCA mutations developed cancer, and many died. Now that there are genetic tests, there are choices. They're just lousy choices. If you have a BRCA1 or BRCA2 mutation, your lifetime risk of developing breast cancer is as high as 80%. Your risk of ovarian cancer as high as 45%. And while breast and ovarian cancer are the best known BRCA-related cancers, both men and women with these mutations have a higher incidence of other cancers as well. The Basser Center for BRCA is the only center in the world solely devoted to BRCA-related cancers. It's a global hub, a place for families to get educated, receive genetic counseling, manage their cancer risk, and get treated. It's also a center for cutting-edge science. Basser is breaking down barriers, working with other institutions, and funding innovative research. Everything from developing a preventative vaccine to looking for biomarkers in the blood for early detection. The ultimate goal is to find a cure. So what can you do? First, find out what's in your genes. Look into your family history. Some people are at greater risk. If you're in one of these groups, make an appointment to see a genetic counselor. Second, spread the word. Discuss BRCA with your family and friends. Are they at risk? Third, support the Basser Center for BRCA. Every day, mothers and fathers pass this mutation to future generations. They need better choices than we have now.
Away, I brought my daughter to the hospital to see her mom for the last time. And it was like this is a movie. This is somebody else's life. My wife was 31 when she passed away, and Rachel was 18 months old.
When you get diagnosed with any genetic disorder, it has an impact on the entire family. And that they're always going to have that hanging over them.
I've known about the BRCA test for quite some time, but I was reluctant to get tested because I was petrified to know with finality that I was BRCA positive.
I always joke that I'm either the luckiest person in the room or the most unlucky person in the room, because I've had cancer twice before age 45, but I'm alive, right? And it's because I had the genetic testing.
I was first diagnosed with a pancreatic cancer. The assumption for the doctors and for myself was that it was probably a spread from the breast cancer.
Currently, we know that individuals with BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutations can reduce their risk of cancer. They can't eliminate their risk, but they can reduce their risk significantly. But the choices we have are less than ideal.
I was young, and I decided to have a bilateral mastectomy. And I also removed the ovaries because, as we know, women that present with BRCA have an increased risk of ovarian cancer.
I can make choices that substantially reduce my risk, But don't get me wrong, this sucks. I don't want to get my breast removed. I don't want to have to think about getting my ovaries removed.
The Basser Center for BRCA is the only fully comprehensive center of this kind. We're really trying to provide funding both internally and externally to advance research in this field at the same time as being a resource for patients, their families, and providers.
When I had a non-invasive cancer in my fallopian tubes, this type of cancer you could barely Google. And now the Basser Center has a researcher studying ways to screen for it. I think that's amazing.
If we can understand why BRCA1 and BRCA2 mutation carriers develop cancer, then we have insight into the pathogenesis of cancer, which can be broadly applied across tumor types and really impact many patients regardless of why they develop their cancer.
By studying some of these cancers, it opens the path to researching all cancers.
We really have to step up the research. We need to get funds for a cure, vaccine, whatever we can do.
I just hope that the Basser Center and researchers around the world can accelerate progress and make the world a place where my daughters and my granddaughters and many women don't have to make the same choices I'm making.
I had a son to raise. I have a son to see grow up and go to college, and so I want to live.
You know, we're dreaming big here, and our patients inspire us to not stop trying. We have made a lot of progress, and we're doing really good work, but it's a reminder of how much work we have left to do. We want this to not be a problem for future generations. We want to prevent this altogether.